Woohoo! Another animation. This time we've got a ball moving across the screen, and you guys already know how this is done. We've got a variable x that tells us the position of the ball, a variable speed that tells us how far the ball moves every time, and a familiar draw loop where we're redrawing the background every time, setting a fill color, drawing the ellipse at position x, and every single time we're going to change x to be the old value of x plus this variable speed. So if I make speed smaller and press restart so I can get my ball back, you can see it moves slower. Or I could make it negative and it would move backwards. Or I could make it zero and the ball would stop moving. But as long as speed is not zero, eventually the ball is going to go off the screen. And I can always press this restart button to bring it back, but you know, after a while that gets old. Pressing restart and restart. So how about this? When the ball reaches the right edge of the screen, instead of just going off the screen like it's doing now, I want it to turn around. And I know how to turn the ball around. I can just say speed gets negative 5. If I make the speed negative, then the ball will go backwards. But here's the problem. I only want to change the speed if the ball has reached the right edge. So I think I already said it. I only want to change the speed if the ball has reached the right edge. I think this calls for an if statement. Up until now, we've only been giving the computer commands to run no matter what. If statements are a way to say, hey dude, I want you to run this code, but only under these specific circumstances. So only change the speed if the ball has reached the right edge. And here's how it looks in code. All you do is type if, and then a pair of parentheses, and then a pair of brackets. And then inside the parentheses, we're going to put the condition, and inside the brackets, we're going to put the code to run. So the way it works is, if this condition is true, then run this code. Otherwise, don't bother. So in our case, the condition is the ball reaching the right edge. How do we know if the ball has reached the right edge? Well, we've got this variable x that tells us where the ball is, and I know that the edge of the canvas is x position 400. So let's see. When x is greater than 400, then we know that the ball has gone past the right edge a little bit. So let's see how that works. And then the code to run, we already said before, we're just going to change speed. Speed gets negative 5. All right, so I'm going to press restart and let's see what happens. So this time, when the ball reaches the right edge, it bounces! Yay! And then it keeps going off the screen. But it's okay, because we can do the same thing on the other side. So this time, we want to check if the ball has reached the left edge. So that's when x is less than, the left edge is 0. And what we want to do is make speed positive again. So we're going to get speed gets 5. All right, and I'm going to press restart. And this time, boing, boing, boing. Yay, it works. And I know we're checking to see if the ball has gone past the edges, but it feels like it's going a little too far past the edges. And if you remember, these two parameters control where the center of the ellipse is drawn. So right now, by the time the center reaches the edge, half the ellipse has already gone past the edge. So if we want to fix that, we can just stop the ellipse a little sooner. So if our edge is here at 400, and we want to stop our ellipse when it gets to here, and we can see from the function call that the ellipse has width 50. So that means from the center to the edge, that's going to be 25. So we want to stop it when the center reaches 375, because that's 400 minus 25. So instead of checking for x greater than 400, I'm going to check x greater than 375. Instead of checking for x less than 0, I'll check for x less than 25. And now it's perfect! Yay! Look at that ball bounce!